Okay, we're close now. We're close now. Okay, so here's the thing. Maybe, hopefully you worked on that exercise. What do we have now? We have an array. It's got two spots in it. Pretend for a moment that it had three spots in it. And what does our code look like? It looks like this. Let's say we want to display all of the bubbles. We have to say bubbles index 0 display, bubbles index 1 display, bubbles index 2 display. With the knowledge that we have right now, the way that we've done everything, we have three lines of code. This leads us to wonder, when we have 1,000 bubbles, will we have 1,000 lines of code? I think I've said that in every single video up until now. Maybe I'm just repeating myself. I have no idea. But this is the concept. This is where we're going. This is the goal. This is very exciting. Pretend you're excited. Just try. I'm trying. I'm trying to pretend. I actually do feel genuinely excited. Sort of. Okay, so how are we going to do this? Let's look at something we learned about a few videos back. Let's look at a loop. I'm going to write out this loop for you. For, actually, this is exciting. I just got excited about it. Okay, it's I equals 0. I is less than 3. I plus plus. And I'm going to write inside this line of code, I mean this loop, inside the structure, I'm going to write print ln I. Okay? This is momentous. Let's actually go and take a look at the output of this. Print ln I. When I run this, what's down at the bottom down here, if you could see that? 0, 1, and 2. What prints out? First, I is 0. Is I 0 less than 3? Yes, it is. Print I, 0. I equals 0. Then I plus plus, I is 1. Is 1 less than 3? Yes. Print I, 1. Is I plus plus, I is 2. Is 2 less than 3? Yes. Print I, yes. I plus plus, I equals 3. Is 3 less than 3? No. Exit the loop. This is the output we get from this loop. Notice anything similar? Take a look at these values and take a look at these values. This just so happens to be a structure where we have a variable called I that starts at 0, then becomes 1, then becomes 2, and then completes. Well, isn't that what we needed to do? We needed to display bubble 0, then display bubble 1, then display bubbles 2. What if, instead of saying print I here, we said bubbles index I dot display? What we've now done is we've essentially said, instead of individually referencing each index with a hard-coded number, let's use a variable that counts through all those numbers and repeat over and over again. Bubbles index I for when I is 0. Bubbles index I for when I is 1. Bubbles index I for when I is 2. And we have now condensed these three lines of code essentially into one line of code. It's 3 with the loop part. It's actually 4 with the print. But, you know, once this goes all the way up to 999, this is still going to be the same length. The only thing that's going to change here is we want I to go up to 1,000. So let's look. This is huge, by the way. You know, let's put this into our program and see what happens. Okay. We don't need to save that. So let's go down here and say, okay, for int I equals 0, I is less than, and right now we have 2, I plus plus, and we don't need both of these anymore. All we need is to reference index I. Let's run this program and see if we get the same result. We get the same result. Instead of having to say ascend display and top for 0, ascend display and top for 1, we now just say it for I. For I. I. okay. Pretty good so far, but we still initialized each bubble individually. You know, what if we wanted to have different sizes? What are we going to do? Well, let's don't worry about that right now. Let's take this and go up here and do the same thing for initializing. Bubbles index I. Let's run this again. Now, instead of having to initialize each one individually, we're initializing each one in that loop. They all have the same size, but we'll get to that in a moment. Great. We're close. 5 minutes, 30 seconds. Actually, that's probably not the time you see. That's a arbitrary time that I put up there. Let's change this now. Let's not get too crazy. Let's just make this 20. Okay, now we got 20 bubbles. Let's run it. 2 bubbles. Shoot, what happened? Well, we updated the array to have 20 spots in it, but our loop is still only looping to 2. So we're only using 2 parts of the array, even though the array itself has 20 spots. So we could fix this by changing this to 20 and this to 20. Now let's run this. 20 bubbles, oh my God. Okay, there's 20 bubbles now. And look, by the way, I should really point out something very, very important. Incredibly important. Notice this bubble tab over here? We haven't touched this once. All of these videos about arrays, we've never touched this bubble class. We're not doing anything to the object that's different. It's the same object. All we're doing is figuring out how to make a list of many of them. To have one or many, the object is still the same. So let's go for it. Let's just go for 1,000. And by the way, this is driving me crazy. I'm going to have 1,000. I got to change 1,000 here, then here, then here. I got to change 20 to 1,000, 20 to 1,000. This is kind of a problem because really, you could be referencing this array in a zillion places in your code. Well, one of the things about an array that I haven't pointed out to you is it has a property, a length property. We can actually access the length of that array directly dynamically. So instead of typing 20 here, I can say bubbles.length. And I can say bubbles.length. And now we have 20 bubbles. It's the same program, but watch this. I could go back and say 3. 3 bubbles. And here we go. get ready to like stand up and applaud, which you're totally not going to do, because why would you? That would be weird. We got 1,000. Oh, it's so sad. There's 1,000 bubbles there, but it's running kind of slow. So we kind of ran into something here. We ran into the fact that it's slow to draw a ton of stuff on the screen. This is actually kind of a little bit of an aside, but an important point nonetheless, that generally speaking, the thing that's going to make your processing program run slow is drawing too much stuff, not calculating too many numbers or having too many lines of code, but drawing too much stuff. Now, at some point, we'll have to have a video. I'm sure we could get, I know for a fact we could get this to run faster through various optimizations, in particular using a different drawing mode with hardware acceleration, which I'm just kind of rambling about right now. We could even just try that, by the way, by saying, I'm going to change it to P2D, which is just throwing in a random thing into this video. Yeah, that's better. It's kind of working. Anyway, it's a little bit faster, but more likely. So, by the way, let me just mention what I did. P2D is what I've done here in the size function is in the last parameter, I can specify what behind the scenes rendering engine do I want to use. This really has nothing to do with the array topic, but I can't stop. And what's the deal with that? It's, you know, you have to imagine like there's this team of people sitting inside processing and they're just waiting to like draw all the pixels on the screen, but there's like 2 separate teams. There's the default team when you don't say anything in size, and there's the P2D team. There's also the P3D team for when you're like, I need to draw stuff in 3D, and they jumped into action and start drawing stuff. P2D and P3D use the graphics card in a particular way, farm out a lot of the rendering to the graphics card, which can make things a lot faster. They use OpenGL, which is a term you can now Google and look up if you're not familiar with it. But let's just go back and make 300 bubbles and get rid of P2D. And this is a nice place to sort of just like watch our bubbles. 300. I can't tell actually if that's running slow or fast or what. I think all that alpha. You know what's actually slowing things down? All that alpha makes things pretty slow. To make it look like a bubble, we don't need a fill. And watch how much faster this is going to be. Look at that. That's nice and fast now, I think. I don't know what's slow, what's fast anymore. So they don't really look like bubbles, but whatever. So it's funny because when I did this the other day, they really looked like bubbles, and I don't know what this looks like. They're probably going to shut off because I think I need to stop now. Okay, so there's a couple nuances to this. Edit the last 1 minute out, please. There's a couple nuances to this. One is that when you're initializing a bunch of objects this way, you only have one line of code to initialize the objects. In essence, we're initializing every object identically. So one thing that we can look at here is that why is there variation? It's because in the constructor, a lot of the parameters are set randomly. X is a random location, the speed is a random value. So this is a way we have a wide variety, and there might be some other algorithm for which you would initialize these parameters. But one thing that you can do that is quite common, let's just go back to like 25 bubbles for a second. There's 25 bubbles, okay? Let's go back and see those 25 bubbles. What if I did this? And this is going to be a little bit confusing, and I times 4. Let's run this. Notice now I have bubbles of varying size. In fact, each bubble has a particularly unique size. The first one is 0, the second one is 4, the next one is 8, the next one is 12, right? The next one is 16, the next one is 20. Right? I'm using the fact that I'm counting through bubble 0, and I'm using the fact that its index is 0 to assign a size. Index is 1 to assign a size. This is one way of doing it. I could also have just done something random right here. And now I have bubbles of all random sizes. So the point is, what's happening now, and I can't believe this is, that stopped recording a while ago. Or just now. I still have a minute. I'm just over here. So this stopped. But this is definitely going to cut out of me any second. So try this. Try now, make your objects, make an array, use a loop, and see how do you initialize that array of objects. Are they all the same? Is it through random? Is it an algorithm based on counting? Give that a try and see how you do.